The path to the moon literally led through Bucks County, Pennsylvania. Research and testing at the Naval Air Development Center were crucial to the program. For example, NASA used this tower to test ejector seats.
Airplanes had advanced and they were now moving and flying so fast that a pilot could no longer simply open the canopy and jump out. You need a rocket-powered seat.
The ejection seat would be attached to the rails at the bottom.
They load it up with explosives and literally blow you up the side of this thing.
Would humans be able to survive high G forces?
A typical human standing upright, you about 5 or 6 G's, you're gonna pass out.
Enter the Iron Maiden.
Flanagan Gray was determined to find the ultimate limit of what a human could take.
So how did it work?
Water does not compress. So if your body is surrounded by something that does not compress, then your body will be able to survive these high G's. They would lift the top off. Flanagan Gray sat in there and endured a bone-crushing 31.25 G's. And certainly that all went into developing the technologies to help our astronauts.
These are just a few of the great artifacts on display at the Mercer right now, including the jacket of test pilot Betty Skelton.
She performed very daring maneuvers. She was brought to Johnsville to train with the Mercury astronauts.
Learning these stories and seeing these artifacts in person makes all of it feel that much more human and impressive. It was brilliant, courageous work.
Training and equipment all combined to help us prepare our astronauts to get to the moon. That was all done locally here in Bucks County, Pennsylvania.